Hey guys, today I'm going to be sharing a few of my tips and tricks on how to better listen to your intuition based on my own journey on my spiritual path, my life's path, whatever you may call it. I've just found so much clarity and better insight about my own intuition that I'm just so excited to share with the world. And the only way that these can actually be beneficial to your own life is that if you actually use them, or else they'll merely be philosophical. So you don't want that to go to waste, and you want to actually implement it into your life. So without further ado, let's get started. So the first way that I found really, really great success in listening to my intuition is all about the ego and soul partnership. Now, I used to think that the ego was the shadowy, dark part of being a human, but it is actually just how you perceive it. And it can go either in the negative route or it can go in the positive direction. It's really subjective. So with this partnership, you can either allow it to help you grow as a human being or allow it to be of your detriment. I found that if you allow your soul to go through and really enliven and move through your ego, you will really live an incredible life. What I mean by that is really allow all of your dreams, your passions, your desires, your wants, your likes, everything that makes you you, really come out through your ego, because your soul is really trying to access the physical world, in my opinion, through the ego in order to live out those dreams, desires, and all those amazing things that you essentially came here to do, be, and have. So really take into consideration the ego and the soul partnership together. A great tip that you can do in helping align that ego and soul is basically write down a list of all of your dreams, desires, passions, and all those great, amazing things that make you you, and really take the time to read them one by one and really feel what it feels like to exude that out of your ego, meaning living authentically, being the desires and passions in real life. And you'll be really surprised, because those amazing and wonderful aspects that you hold within yourself, that your soul is really trying to express through that ego, through your ego, is definitely you. And it's an amazing, incredible feeling once you find that alignment and power with the partnership of the ego and soul. So I highly recommend that. However, sometimes we do have egos that have untrue paradigms that really need some cleansing and getting rid of because of that negative thought pattern or negative assumption that is hindering our souls from going through and accessing our ego into the physical realm. All right, secondly is really listen to the feelings and emotions within your body. And we all know, we've all heard, you know, you have that gut feeling of something going really great or something really going not so great. We all have that feeling of emotion and sensations in our own physical bodies that really, really helps us access our intuition and helps us understand it from a listening point of view. So if you guys are familiar with Abraham Hicks, she always talks about listening to your guidance system. We all came into this life, time, space, and reality with a guidance system, which is basically how we feel and those emotions that come from those feelings. So I really, really, really encourage you all to really listen to those emotions and feelings that come from your body, because they are not of any accident at all. Of course, there are aspects that may be a little bit hindered by a negative part of our egos that are causing, you know, untrue sensations that are not from the intuition. But once we peel back the layers of who we are and we live authentically every single day and we, you know, strive to grow and become our authentic best versions, you will just realize when the feelings are right and when the feelings are kind of not from the intuition itself. So I highly, highly recommend that you start feeling just the little things and the big things, and you'll start to realize, oh my gosh, I'm my heart, my gut feeling, everything in my body, you know, is guiding me in the right direction. And it never, never fails. I've never had a moment where I was like, I wish I didn't go and listen to my heart, because that has never happened. So always listen to your heart, because the heart really permeates those feelings and emotions. So my tip on how to better feel those emotions, feel that gut feeling, feel the heart: pick something that you must really feel intuitively drawn to, such as, let's say, cooking or baking. For example, when you're cooking something, really feel from your heart what needs to be added or not added into the recipe. For example, there should be a little bit more salt, there should be a little bit more cinnamon. Just feel from your body what feels right to go in and not in the recipe. For me, I love cooking and baking, so I can really sense what my body feels through the act of putting those ingredients in the actual recipe. So I highly recommend you try that, especially with cooking or baking. All right, next is move your body. Now this is, you know, of course intuitive, because we need that good exercise, we need movement, we need to move our blood, we need to move our, just everything in our bodies to sustain well-being and health. So with that being said, of course we have that biology that impacts our intuition as physical beings. And what I mean by that is, we definitely do, and this is completely normal, we do get into bouts of a little bit of resistance and strain and, you know, rigidity sometimes in the body. And I think that's normal, because, you know, if you're sitting, you have to get up and move a little bit after you're done sitting, of course, right? So I feel that, you know, always moving your body daily, whether it's by taking a walk, going for a spin class, or just dancing around, it is so imperative in making sure that you can better listen to your intuition. And when the body is rigid and really, you know, restrained and, you know, restricted, it's so much harder to tap into your intuitive senses, because you're not allowing the body, the physical temporal you, to allow the, you know, the non-physical you to really interact and flow, you know, easily. So really, really move your body and make it a habit. No matter how light, no matter how powerful it is, you just want to keep yourself moving and, you know, grooving and flowing and all that good stuff. And a really, really great tip is exercise. Like I said this before, of course you can do whatever you like. However, exercise really ups the game of your hormones, those feel-good hormones, to fire away and to really, really allow your body to find balance and that, you know, internal peace, as well as being externally peaceful as well. So basically what I'm trying to say is that exercise really, really helps alleviate all of the tension inside your mind and your body, and allows you to, you know, listen and tap into that intuition that might be muted due to, you know, that restriction of the body, that strain, that like resistance, you know what I mean? So really, really take the time and move your body through exercise. I personally love, 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 love belly dance, but you have to find something that really makes you feel incredible and that makes you feel such purpose in living, basically. All right, so next is embrace and be in nature. I always find alignment when I go back outside and I get in under the sky, I look at the sky, I feel the wind on my skin, I see, you know, the beautiful birds flying, the trees flowing, and, you know, just dancing around. It's so, so important for your intuition and for the betterment of your understanding and listening of your intuition to go outside and be with nature, because we come from the earth, literally, and we will go back to the earth. So everything that is us is out there, and there's just that sense of peace and serenity when you're back out in nature. And when it comes to listening to your intuition, it's just that time of being alone and allowing yourself to feel the essence of you, vibing with the, you know, totality of Earth. It's just such an amazing, amazing feeling that allows you to come back to yourself and find that guidance system and permeate it outside of your physical body. So I highly recommend you take at least one time of your day to get outside and be under the stars, be under the clouds, the sky, whatever, and just feel. And you'll really feel alignment again, especially if you were feeling a little bit uneasy or out of balance. You'll just find that collective unity with nature and the whole universe as well. So my tip is to at least once a day go outside and be under natural light. Allow the sun to kiss your skin and just soak that up all in so that you can better listen to your intuition. And once you do that, your mind is completely clear and ready to receive. And even on warmer days, I know it's going to be winter soon, however, on warmer days, take off your shoes and ground yourself with your feet to the earth so that you can feel that connection again with the planet itself. And last but not least, take the time to laugh and connect with beautiful souls all around you. And it doesn't matter if you have someone in the direct vicinity of you or another human being. It can be a plant, it can be an animal, it can be, you know, a tree, it can be anything, because there is life in every single form. Because basically when you find that connection with anything, you allow yourself to be yourself. By allowing yourself to open up and connect with other beings of the planet helps you really tune in to your own intuition. Because I can't even tell you so many times where I've gotten out of alignment and out of balance, and it wasn't until I found connection with my mom, with my friend, or anything for that matter, I just remembered who I was and I could intuitively come back to me as myself. Whenever you feel especially an intuitive fog and a hard time listening to your intuition, go out and find something or someone to have a soul connection with. You will ultimately feel that alignment again, so that when you feel aligned, you're better able to listen to your intuitive senses. So a tip that I have in doing so would be carving out a time where you can have a bit of tea time or some special time with a loved one or something special for yourself to really go and vent and just release everything so that you're better able to receive all that beautiful intuitive guidance from your higher self. And remember, when your glass is completely full, there's just no way that it can add anything else into the cup. So it's always good to just let everything out, let yourself be, and remember who you are so that your intuition can come back and guide you again. And there you have it, a few different ways that have really helped me tap into my intuition. I hope that these ways have really, really helped you in some way, shape, or form. Let me know of any of your comments down below. I'd love to know. And don't forget to check out my blog, because all of the details to this video in written form are going to be posted on this blog post on my blog at elizabethmeraki.com. And yeah, let me know what you think. And thank you so, so, so much for all of you subscribing and just supporting my channel. I'm just so, so grateful to you all. Much love and light to you wherever you are on this planet. And I will see you very soon in my next video.